I'm Anne from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you. Today, I'm thinking about using balloons for transportation. Balloons were the first way that people were able to fly high up above the Earth, and they really caught people's imaginations. Here's a drawing made in 1825 of gas balloons being used in London town for transportation. The artist imagined funny ideas, like people selling snacks to the balloonists off the top of buildings. Although balloons were very popular, they never got to be quite as common as ground transportation. Another artist, around the same time, made this drawing of a whole town that could fly above the earth. This included houses, a church, lookout places, and storage barrels. This idea was not really possible, but we have a model of this imaginative balloon in the museum. Today, balloon festivals are a popular entertainment and still a fun and colorful way to enjoy the view from above the earth. Here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there were three friends who liked to go on adventures together. They were Millie, Ruth, and Lou. One day, they were having a tea party and Lou invited the friends to a balloon festival. Lou said, "My folks can take us all to see the big hot air balloons, and Mo can come too." "Oh, thank you," said Millie. "Mo and I will love to go." "I wonder what it's like to go up in a hot air balloon." Ruth said, "I remember hearing a story about someone who traveled all over the world in a balloon. What do you think that would be like? Maybe there would be balloon snack shops in the air where you could buy treats." Lou said, "I've heard about houseboats. I think it would be like that, but in the air." Millie said, "It would be fun if you could just take off using a balloon and float wherever you want to go." Ruth said, "These are good stories. Let's write them down and draw pictures and make a storybook." The friends thought that was a great idea, and they decided to gather their art supplies and meet up later to make their storybook about people that lived in the air. They gathered paper, markers, watercolor paints, yarn, staplers, and stickers. Each friend wrote a different story about living in the air. Ruth drew a picture with markers of the hot air balloon snack shop with all of her favorite snacks. Then she added some stickers. Lou drew a whole group of houses and buildings floating on huge balloons in the air, and then she painted the picture with watercolor paint. Millie drew pictures of kids who could fly with their own individual balloons. She glued yarn onto her picture for the balloon strings and the kids' hair and clothes. Then they put their stories together and stapled on a cover made from blue construction paper. Lou wrote the title, "Life in the Air," and they each wrote their name on the cover. Just then Mo came by. "What are you making?" he asked. Millie said, "We're authors. We wrote a book. Would you like to hear the stories?" "Yes," said Mo, and he sat down. Each friend took turns reading their story to Mo. The next day, it was time to go to the balloon festival. They drove to a big field where they saw so many big, colorful balloons with big baskets under them. Some of the balloons were floating in the air. Some of the balloons were on the ground. "Look," said Mo, "that balloon looks like it's on fire." He pointed to a balloon that was lying on the ground. The lady near the balloon laughed. She said, "We're using the burner to heat up the air. That's what makes the balloons float up in the sky." The friends watched as the balloons filled up and started to float up into the sky. "Oh," said Ruth, "look at that pretty purple and blue one." "There are so many beautiful colors," said Millie. "I like the orange, yellow, and red one." Lou said, "We're going for a ride in the green one over there." They all ran over to the balloon and climbed into the basket. Soon they were off the ground and floating over the field. "What a great adventure," said Ruth. "Yes, thank you, Lou, for inviting us," said Millie. "I'm glad to be here with you," said Lou, and they gave each other a high five. It's craft time. Today we're going to make our own books. What you need for this craft is some paper for the inside of your book, construction paper that will become the cover of your book, and you're going to need hole punch, some yarn, and a pencil. And then you'll also need whatever art supplies you're going to use to create the illustrations and drawings for your book. So the first thing we're going to do is make the pages of our book. And for this one, I thought I would have four pages, so I need two pieces of paper to make four pages. And I fold those two in half and crease it nicely. That will become the inside of our book. And now I'm going to put some holes in it, and that will be where we bind it together. So this is going to take three holes, one at the top, one on the bottom, and one in the middle. And you can make these holes go right on the edge of the crease. If it doesn't go quite to the edge, you might have to do it twice just to make sure it goes right through the middle. So you see that those holes. Now, that's going to be useful for when we bind our books together. Now I'm going to make the cover. So I'm going to take my construction paper and just fold it in half. Great, that's going to be our cover. Now, I'm going to take my piece of paper and I'm going to line up the cover and the papers on the inside just to see where do I need to put the holes so that it'll bind together nicely. So I'm going to take my pencil after I have lined that up and just make a mark on each of those places so that I know exactly where to punch my holes. Here we go. You see the little marks that I made, and then those will be the places where I put my hole punch. So I got my hole punch, and I'm gonna punch the holes in 1, 2, 3 spots. Here we go. Now, the next thing to do is to line up the holes from the pages with the holes in the cover and open up the book to the middle. And make sure that those are nicely lined up. See that? Great. Now we're going to do a little sewing to sew our pages together. So I'm going to use my yarn and I go in to the middle hole just like this and pull it through the outside. That's right. Now I'm going to go back through the top hole into the middle of the page and pull it back to the middle. There we go. Now I'm in the inside of my book and I'm going to go back through that middle hole again, that first hole that we started, and pull it out to the outside of the book. And then the last hole sewing that we have to do is to take that page, that same yarn, and go through the top hole. Great. Now you see that we have the two pieces of yarn in the middle, and our pages can be all, make sure our pages are all lined up, and we can just tie that together with a nice square knot. That's going to bind our pages together so that they don't move around, and we can flip them and turn them just like a real book. If you want to, this is what that looks like. You can either trim these to make them smaller, or you can push the knot through the hole so that the knot is on the outside. That's what I did with my book that I did earlier. I put that knot on the outside. I think this one, I'll trim the inside of the book. Then you can choose to do whatever you want with the inside of your book. Maybe you want to make a book a story or a book about something like I did about circles. And so you can put your title on the cover and your name as the author and illustrator, and then choose whatever you want to write on the inside of your book that's beautifully bound, just like a real book. I hope you enjoyed this craft. Try it and become your own author and illustrator. If you like our stories and our crafts, please give us a thumbs up and like this video, and then also subscribe to our YouTube channel so you won't miss one story and you'll get them in your subscription box each month. Thanks for coming and joining us today. Goodbye.